Hey guys, a few weeks back I posted a video on MIUI 8 installation guide for this Eureka. But exactly the day when I posted that review, I was able to see the next version of MIUI 8 available for this phone. And that was based on Marshmallow, and that was the only big issue I was able to get with this previous version. As you can see, it still runs on Lollipop 5.0.2. So with this one, we should be able to update that. Now press the power button and get to the recovery mode. First, click on wipe. Click on advanced wipe, and then select Dalvik, system, data, and then cache. And do not select internal and micro SD. Then swipe it to confirm flash. Once it's done, click on back. Go back to the main screen and then click on install. Then select the MIUI patch ROM zip file which you had previously pasted in your memory card. Click on that and then swipe to confirm flash. This should take about 5 minutes I guess, so please wait patiently until then it gets complete. So it's almost complete, and yes, it is finally done. Then go back, and then click on reboot, and then click on system. So the first boot will take some time, and I will skip to the end of the boot. And something cool. I haven't seen this before in any of the MIUI ROMs, so it's completely different. This progress bar looks really cool and resembles iOS a lot. It's good to see that MIUI is taking some features. And so we are finally booted. Let me quickly set this up. And so we are successfully booted into the Marshmallow ROM. State of the boot, I could notice that this is a lot faster and snappier than the previous ROM. So that's a plus point, I would say. If you were concerned that the previous MIUI ROM was outdated, then this should definitely fix it. It runs on Marshmallow finally. In normal usage, it feels a lot smoother than the previous version, and it's very smooth, transitions were quick, and you also get some few new changes compared to the previous one. The animations and transitions were also quick, and there weren't any big stutter over there. And now we also get a new video app. And the interface is fairly simple, and it resembles the MX player in a lot of ways. You get slider control to change the brightness, volume, and even to fast forward. You also have another app called Waves Mix. It's just another equalizer app with which you can adjust your treble, bass, you can just tinker around. I did also try a few games, and the gameplay was smooth. No lag, no stutter, nothing, and it did play everything well. But I did notice that it did get a little bit warm, but having said that, this has a Snapdragon 615 and it's a usual thing and nothing much to do with the OS. And then all the regular MIUI things, the few tricks, are still available here. And so everything works pretty much well for the most part, but not always. All those things are fine, but let me get to the best part and tell you why you shouldn't be upgrading this one. The main reason why I would never really suggest anybody to upgrade this to Marshmallow is that it's highly unstable, highly inconsistent, and it's full of bugs. Just starts out from everything, just unlocking your device and then going on to the notification tray,
and you try to switch on the data toggle, it just stops working for no reason. And the most basic things like showing the carrier name, showing the signal strength, it doesn't work out of the boot or the first boot itself. You have a separate app for that, something called Fix Signal. And that app just works like a soft reboot or something. It just brings up the signal, and even after you change the SIM for the second time, you just have to do that. It doesn't work automatically. The next biggest bug would be the battery drain itself. For some weird reason, it didn't charge for the first time. I just connected it to my fast charger actually. It was plugged in for around 2 hours and the battery was 20% when I plugged in, and even after those 2 hours it was still at 23%. So I took the charger, plugged it again, started charging it again, but then again it took another hour to reach 94% or something. I didn't have the patience after that, so I just removed that and started using the phone, and just after 30 minutes it dropped to 64. It charges extremely slowly and then it drains very fast. Why? And then another bug is Ulti doesn't work out of the box. That is expected. I haven't used Ulti in any of the ROMs before, but this does have an option for Ulti. It just gives you just allows you to enable Ulti, but the toggle doesn't work. And even without that, the internet wasn't connecting perfectly. The data toggle bug, which was present with the previous ROMs, returned here. It's not like it doesn't work at all. When it works, it's very smooth, fast, responsive, everything that's good. But just randomly it stops working, and that is called a buggy ROM, right? This was surprisingly fluid and just buttery smooth, but I don't know why there are so many bugs. I just got so annoyed that I immediately wanted to stop using this device as my main device. That too, I came from a new phone and I was kind of bored using it for a long time, so I just flashed this and I wanted to try something new. But this just got me annoyed and I was not able to sustain with this for even at least an hour or so. I actually don't find any reason for upgrading this one. And if you definitely want to use a MIUI ROM,
I would still suggest you to go with the previous version that was built on Lollipop. I think that is still a lot better. And I'll also leave a card here to my previous review. You can definitely check that out.
So personally, I wouldn't recommend this to anybody, and particularly if you are using this as your primary phone or if this is your only phone, please don't update this, or else you will regret after that, or you just feel bad for wasting 800 MB of data just like I did. But if this isn't your primary phone, if your phone is just laying around somewhere, or if you wanna try some new things and think around your phone and change your OS, whatever, if you just wanna have fun, you can absolutely do that. You can just go to the link below the description, just download it and flash it and feel bad after doing it, just like I did. I don't wanna blame anybody in this, because even in the website or the forums page, it was clearly mentioned that this has got a lot of bugs and it isn't stable. Not a bad thing on their part, but if you are someone who just saw that and believe that it will be good, just wanted to save you guys from something. So unless and until you have got a lot of time to waste and also a lot of data to waste, you can definitely check this out. It is one of the worst ROMs you could ever get on your device. So that's pretty much it for this video, and I'll talk to you guys in the next video. Peace out.